any truth to that.
Okay, first and foremost, Mormonism is related best to Masonry in two ways. One, their temple rituals, and two, their idea of taking man and helping him progress and get better and better in his flesh and self. That is both of those things Mormonism borrowed from Masonry. Second point about Masonry. There was a man named William Morgan who had a wife, and he was going to reveal the secrets of Masonry way back in the 1820s. William Morgan was discovered by the Masons to have done had plans to do this, and they took him and they killed him. This was the beginning of the end of the popularity of Masonry in America today. His wife, his widow, who he left behind, was one of Joseph Smith's first polygamous wives. The third thing about polygamy and about Masonry and Mormonism is that Joseph Smith in Nauvoo allowed a Masonic temple to be there. He went through, he reached the highest enlightened degree, 33rd degree, I believe, at that point in a matter of days. And then 6 weeks, 4 weeks later, he produced the LDS Mormon temple ceremony.
Oh.
So, and in terms of were they the ones who killed him, it's speculation. Some believe it was them. Some believe it was just an angry mob fearing the Mormons and all their marching around in military and saying they're going to take over the world. And some believe it was actually LDS members who were tired of Joseph Smith's revelations on polygamy and being ordained king of the world and all that stuff, and so that they actually killed him. And that some even say Brigham Young was behind it and got it going, and he left town so they could do the job. All of it's speculation. We don't really know who did it.
Yeah. Huh.
Okay?
All right. Hey, thanks for clearing that up.
Hey, William.